Now let's talk about the epicyclic gear train. So this is how an epicyclic gear train looks like. It is not necessarily it will be the same configuration, okay, but this is how it looks like. It has multiple components. Now what do we understand by epicyclic gear train? So if you look at this, there are three components in this. You have 1, 2, and 3. So you have two gears and one arm. Gear 2 is a fixed gear, means it cannot move its position. It will only rotate about this center of rotation, which is O. Whereas for this arm 3, one end of this arm is fixed at the center O and the other is at the center O1. This center O1 can, you know, move about because this arm can also rotate about this point O. Okay, so the main purpose of having an epicyclic gear train is that you can fix these individual components one by one to get different gear ratios and different configurations. For example, if I make this arm stationary, okay, so what will happen? It will become a simple gear train because this center will also become fixed. This is already fixed, so you will just have a simple gear train. Okay, next, if I make gear 2 fixed, means gear 2 cannot rotate even, so I will have to give drive to this arm. So when I give drive to the arm, this entire gear 1 would start to rotate about the center O and will also rotate, you know, completely about this entire gear. Okay, maybe we can fix gear 1? No, we cannot fix gear 1 because when you try to fix gear 1, your gear 2 will start to move around gear 1 because, and that cannot happen because gear 2 is a fixed gear. Okay, gear 2 is a fixed gear. You cannot have this. Okay, so there are certain limitations as well. So you have to recognize that which configuration is possible, which is not. So in this case, you cannot fix gear 1, but you can fix arm 3 and gear 2. Okay, so this is the meaning of epicyclic gear train. That is, by fixing different components, you'll get different configurations and resulting gear ratios. Okay, so now in the next video, we'll look at a method to solve the epicyclic gear train problem. And there are two methods basically. The first one is the relative velocity method, but we'll not look at that. We'll look at the tabular method. So we'll take the help of a table to solve the problem on the epicyclic gear train.